Try this matchup. Low prices and faster checkout. You can count on it at Fry's.
At the end of the day, I need to make the decisions that's right for Eric Gordon, just before I came to Arizona. And I have a great foundation. You know, my parents, my mom and my dad and my brother and sister, I talked to them a lot. I talked to the coaching staff and I talked to my players and made sure everything was good to go. You know, from about the first grade, I had wanted to compete at the highest level. So that's what I intend on doing next year, and I'm going to go to the NBA.
This is the Arizona Daily Star Wildcats Video Extra, brought to you by Fry's Food Stores. I'm Zach Rosenblatt here with Bruce Pasco. We're in the press conference room at McHale Center. We just got out of the press conference for the NBA, the guys declaring for the NBA. Some guys decided they're staying. I guess, Bruce, any surprises from the press conference today?
Nah, the big news was that Rondae Hollis-Jefferson's staying. I mean, everybody knew that Gordon and Johnson were pretty much on the way out, and it was, in fact, the real surprise is that Rondae really sounded like he didn't really think that much about it. He basically said, I want to be a top 10 pick, I think I can do it, and he's going to need to come back, but he can do it if he comes back and shows improvement, gets a jump shot, and plays a little bit bigger role. But he's got that kind of potential, and if he came out now, maybe gets in the first round, probably gets in the first round, but there's a big difference money-wise if you're in the top 10 versus the end of the first round, so he can actually have fun, maybe get this team in the Final Four next year and make money on the fact if you go a lot higher next year. It's probably a good decision for him.
And then talking about the first round, I guess, in terms of Nick Johnson, do you feel like he can improve himself and get into the first round, or is he too undersized? Like, what's your take on his projection, I guess?
Yeah, it's the old deal, I think, with Nick, where he's going to be one of those guys where a certain team's going to have to really fall in love with him because he's a unique player. He can be a niche player in the NBA. I think whether he goes in the first or second round, I think he can do that. And I think this pre-draft process is really going to help him because he is so explosive. He's so athletic. I think his vertical leap that he tested for here was better than the vertical leap that had been set at the NBA Combine in all the times they've had the Combine. So you imagine he goes there this year, he's going to really open up some eyes, and people might want to take a chance on him. So it's going to be really interesting. He's going to be fun to watch throughout this process and see what happens.
Again, this is the Wildcats Video Extra, brought to you by Fry's Food Stores. And Nick obviously was a leader for this team. There's going to be maybe a leadership void with him leaving. They talked a lot about that in the press conference today. Who do you see filling that role?
Yeah, I agree. That's the biggest thing. I mean, you know, they've got Stanley Johnson coming in and Kadeem Allen coming in. They got scoring guards. But what they really lose with Nick is that leadership and the chemistry and the way, the personality he has. He'll just go up to a guy, he's quiet, and start having a good time with him. Everybody likes Nick. Everybody. Coaches, players, recruits, and you just can't replace that easily. However, they have a really good leader also in T.J. McConnell, and I think some of the other guys are maybe a little on the quieter side, but they're all pretty good guys that are well-respected, guys like Caleb Tarzewski and Brandon Ashley here today. I think Rondae, you know, is kind of an easygoing guy, but I think people are going to listen to him more and more, and he's well-liked as well. So, you know, a lot of guys all the way around. But it's got to start with TJ, of course, having the ball and being the veteran of this team.
Yeah, and obviously it's really early, and, you know, we don't know what's going to happen with the lineup and things like that, but they have so many new pieces coming in. It's going to be a pretty deep team. Do you have any sense of what the starting lineup might be, if Rondae will come off the bench or he'll stay in the starting lineup now? Like, I guess, what are your thoughts on that?
Well, that's what I asked Sean Miller that, and of course it's crazy early to ask those kind of things, but, you know, I think you could make a case where he might want to still come off the bench because they've got Stanley Johnson coming in again, Allen, and you got Gabe York, who's a returning starter, but, you know, maybe you go Rondae playing so well as he did at the end of this year. Maybe he starts this time along with, say, Stanley Johnson, and then you bring off, you know, Gabe York and off the bench and as well with Allen. But, you know, there's a lot remains to be seen there, but it's going to be – they have a lot of good options, that's for sure.
And then in terms of Stanley Johnson, I guess, do you see him as somebody who can come in and contribute the way Aaron Gordon did right away?
Yeah, I do. I do. I think they're different players, but Stanley's physically ready. He's very mature, loves the game, really super intense, I think he'll make a big impact, yeah.
All right, that'll do it. This has been the Arizona Daily Star Wildcats Video Extra. For Bruce Pasco, I'm Zach Rosenblatt. Have a good one.